अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव रिवाइज्ड ऑल द डेफिनेशंस ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1 इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 2 एंड रिवाइज ऑल दीज डेफिनेशन रिलेटेड टू दिस चैप्टर. द चैप्टर नंबर 2 इज अबाउट रैशनल नंबर्स. सो फर्स्टली वी विल डिफाइन द नंबर्स, रैशनल नंबर्स, सॉरी. As we know that the natural numbers are counting numbers and the whole numbers are all the natural numbers including zero. And we have learned in previous class that some numbers are negative with negative sign. And all these numbers with negative and positive signs are called integers. But if we see some numbers like these examples like a fraction, then what are these? These are called rational numbers. So defining rational numbers, the definition of rational number is that a number that can be expressed in the form of P over Q. P over Q is a fraction where P and Q are variables, and any integer can be written in the these places. Okay, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to zero. It is the condition that must be fulfilled that Q must not be zero, because zero dividing by zero is not defined in now. Okay, so Q must not be equal to zero is called that. Then this type of fractions are called rational numbers. Some examples are 3/2, 4/7, -2/5, and if there is -1/-6, then it is also called a rational number. Okay, representation of rational number. It is about exercise number 2.1, that how to represent a rational number on a number line. Then so you will read all the method given here. Okay, we have discussed already in the exercise. Next we will see some properties of rational number. Firstly, we will know or learn how to add the rational numbers. If P over Q and R over S, or sorry, P over S and R, Q over S, where these are like some like fractions, okay, where the denominators are same, or any two rational numbers with the same denominators, then we shall add these numbers as combining the denominator as this and add the numerators in the numerator. Okay, S is combined in the denominator and P and Q are adding on the numerator. Okay, but if the denominators are also different, then the method is that multiply denominators equally. Okay, and multiply the first numerator with second denominator and second numerator with first denominator, or you can say that the factor that we would multiply with Q to get QS, then multiply it with numerator, and similarly the factor that we would multiply with S to get QS, then we will multiply that factor with numerator. Okay, this is the method. Similarly, we will subtract these the rational numbers with the same method. If they like fractions, then we will add we will solve it as the method of like fractions, addition of like fractions, and if there are different denominators, then we will subtract those fractions as we have discussed in addition. Now, additive inverse. Additive inverse means opposite of that fraction, or the factor that we will add in the first fraction or the rational number, then we will get zero. That is called the additive inverse. Okay, consider that P over Q and Q minus P over Q, there are two fractions with numerator where numerator and denominator is the same, but there is a difference, that is a negative sign. Okay, all the numbers are same but sign is different. Are any two rational numbers, then we can add them by the following method, like this: P over Q plus minus P over Q. These are like fractions, so Q will be common, and P plus minus minus is equal to 0. 0 divided by 2 is also 0. we can examine that the sum of those these two fractions rational numbers is zero. Hence, two rational numbers are called the additive inverse of each other, and zero is not the additive identity. Zero is not the additive identity. It is also a definition. Okay, if additive inverse is completely with the definition of additive identity. Okay, students. Now, here are the method of multiplication of rational numbers. We can multiply two rational numbers like the method multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator and then simplify it in the lowest form. Okay, read out the method rule. Multiply the numerator of one rational number with by the numerator of another rational number. Similarly, multiply denominators of both rational numbers with the same method. Multiplicative inverse is that fraction that we would multiply with first fraction and we will get 1. That fraction is called the multiplicative inverse of first fraction. Consider that two rational numbers p over q and q over p are the fractions where denominator numbers are same, but there the second number or second fraction is the reciprocal of first fraction. Okay, we find the product by the following formula. We will multiply this in the, with the same formula, p multiplied by q and q multiplied by p, and if we simplify it we will get 1. Okay, then we have noticed that the answer is 1. Hence, two rational numbers p over q and q over p are the multiplicative inverse of each other, and 1 is called the multiplicative identity. Similarly, with as the, we have discussed in additive identity, we will write complete definition including multiplicative identity. Okay, students, now here's some information for you that for any non-zero rational number p over q, rational number p, non-zero means there in both numerator and denominator will not be equal to zero, and the rational number q or p are its reciprocal. Okay, if we multiply that, the multiplicative inverse is also called the reciprocal of that fraction. Okay, the number zero has no reciprocal. It is also an informative sentence, and the multiplicative inverse of non-zero rational number is its reciprocal, as we have discussed in first bullet. Division of rational numbers. If we have to divide the rational number, find the multiplicative inverse of the divisor. Okay, multiply it with dividend, and according to the rule of multiplication. Simply, we will do that. If there are two fractions p over q and r over s, and we have to divide these fractions, then simply we will change division sign into multiplication and take the reciprocal of next fraction, and after that we will solve it with the method of multiplication of rational numbers. Okay, students, now read all the definitions and rules for here is the finding reciprocal of rational number. There is a matter of to find the reciprocal of rational numbers. You will just read out this to make it easy for you. Okay, now come, there are some properties of rational numbers, as we have discussed that commutative property and associative property. So it is similar to that in that, as we have discussed in chapter number 1. So you will just read out this, and method is formula. Okay, students, associative property, we will also read out the definition, and distributive property, multiplication over addition and subtraction. It is also a property that if you have to multiply and multiply one fraction with any two fractions, okay, then the method is called distributive property. You can also read out from here. Okay, comparison of rational numbers. If we have to compare two rational numbers, that which number is greater, which fraction is less, then the method is given that comparison of integer fraction is in our previous class. Similarly, we compare the rational numbers by using the same rules. Comparison, as we have discussed in previous class. Okay, we'll just do that. Common denominators, and if the numerator is, we will check the numerator, which number is greater, then the fraction will be greater, and if the smaller number in numerator, then the fraction will be smaller. Okay, students, and with this we have completed all the definitions. You have to learn it by your heart, and also revise the review exercise and summary फॉर योर हेल्प. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, टेक केयर. अल्लाह हाफिज़.